In this video, I explain advantages and disadvantages of gas turbine over internal combustion engine. So first we understand the advantages of gas turbine compared to the IC engine. So first advantage of the gas turbine is, gas turbine is a rotary machine, okay, and the IC engine have a lots of reciprocating parts, means it is called as the reciprocating machines, okay. So we know that when the reciprocating motions are there, the vibrations are more, okay, and in a gas turbine, it is a rotary machine, means the vibrations are very less or it is absent, okay, and if vibration are less, then what, easy balancing of the machine is done and the small foundations are required for the gas turbine power plant. So in IC engine what happened, that is the vibrations are more, and due to more vibrations we are required a big foundations and the balancings are difficult. Second advantage of a gas turbine power plant is less number of parts, and that is a less number of parts means it is easier to the maintain or a maintenance, and the maintenance cost of a gas turbine is less, about 60% compared to the diesel engine power plant. Means compared to the diesel engine power plant, maintenance of the gas turbine power plant is the less than 60%. Means suppose the maintenance cost of the diesel engine is 1 lakh rupees per year, then for the gas turbine power plant it is only 40,000 rupees. Third point, high specific power output. Means the power output is the higher compared to the IC engine, and weight of gas turbine plant is much less compared to the IC engine plant. Means suppose we are discussing for the same power output, weight of the gas turbine is low compared to the IC engine. So weight to power ratio of a gas turbine plant is about 0.18 kg per HP, while it is 0.5 kg per HP for IC engine. Means suppose we install the IC engine and the output power is 1 HP, okay, and its weight is 0.5 kg, and for the gas turbine its weight is only 18 kg for a 1 HP power. The cooling requirement of gas turbine is very less compared to the IC engine. Means the cooling requirement is less, means like as the cooling is done either by using the air cooling system or by water cooling systems or by using the specific fluid or by using the oils, its coolings are carried out. So absence of radiator is the big advantage in a case of the automotive use of gas turbine. And suppose we use the gas turbine in a automobile vehicles, okay, in our bike or a car, you see that is a IC engine are there, okay, and instance of this IC engine we use the gas turbine in a bike, then what happen, we are not required the radiators, okay, so we reduce the cost of the radiators. So in a few of the racing car this gas turbine system is already used, okay, so in a application of the gas turbine power plant we discuss about it. The capacity of IC engine is limited due to detonations or knocking and low volumetric efficiency at the high speed. Means if we run the IC engine at the very high speed, so it's have a number of problems like as the detonations or a knocking and a low volumetric efficiency. The capacity of gas turbine can be increased with use of highly developed materials of a gas turbines, like as the high inlet temperature is also achieved. Means if we use the new developed materials, then we can increase this capacity of the gas turbine power plant easily, and we are not face any problems like as the detonations, knocking and the volumetric efficiencies. Next advantage, the gas turbine require less lubricating oil as compared to diesel engine power plant. Means lubricating oil require is very less compared to the diesel engines. The cost of lubricating oil in a case of gas turbine is about 0.5 to 1% of the total fuel cost, while it is about 10 to 15% that for the diesel engines. Okay, so this cost of the lubricating oil is very reduced, okay, compared to the fuel cost. Okay, so in a diesel engine 10 to 15% is there, in a gas turbine it is only 0.5 to 1% is there. The closed cycle gas turbine make possible to use any fuel ranging from kerosene to heavy oil and even P10 coal slurry. means in a gas turbine power plant, there is a two type of system is there. There is a one is open cycles and another is the closed cycles. So in a closed cycles, we are able to use any type of the fuels ranging from kerosenes to heavy oils, even a peat and a coal slurry are also used in a gas turbine power plant. Next advantage is a gas turbine plant can be used in conjunction with bottoming steam plant in the combined cycle mode to yield an overall fuel to electricity efficiency of 55%. It means we are also able to run the steam power plant with the gas turbine power plants. Okay. So in a open cycle gas turbine power plant, what happened? We remove the gas to the atmosphere. Okay. So instead of removing this gas to the atmosphere after the expansion process, we can supply this gas to the boiler, and boiler is produced the steam, and by using this steam, we can run the steam power plants. Okay. So by using this bottoming steam plants, or it is also called as the combined cycle modes, then we are able to achieve the efficiency is 55%. And the last advantage is the mechanical efficiency of gas turbine is more than that of for a IC engine. Means mechanical efficiency of the gas turbine is higher than the IC engines. Now, before moving on to these disadvantages, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to power plant engineering and other subject of this mechanical engineering. For more video, I request to visit the playlist. In the playlist, that is a subject wise sections are that, then you can easily find out this video that you required. Now we understand the disadvantages. So first disadvantage, the thermal efficiency of simple gas turbine plant is lower than that of a IC engine. Means suppose we use the simple gas turbine plant, simple means we are not using any intercooling, reheating and the regenerations, at that time the thermal efficiency is lower than the IC engine. In order to get efficiency that of a IC engine, gas turbines will be provided with additional auxiliary such as intercooler, regenerators and the reheaters, and resulting in a complex systems and higher cost of the plant. Means suppose if we need to increase the efficiency of the gas turbine power plant higher than the IC engine, okay, then we need to provide the extra component, means additional auxiliaries like as the intercoolers, regenerators and the reheaters. So when we putting these three different components, then what happened? The complexity is increased and this cost of the system is also increased. The gas turbine is high speed engine and hence it require reduction gear system to reduce the rotational speed of for industrial applications. Means the speed of the gas turbine shaft is very high compared to the IC engine. Okay. For that, if we use this mechanical energy for some industrial applications, we need to use the reduction gears. Means for reducing this RPM of the shaft, we need to use the reduction gears. The temperature of combustion chamber is quite high, therefore its life is comparatively reduced. Means due to high temperatures in the combustion chambers, the life of the combustion chambers are reduced. Also, the cost of manufacturing of a gas turbine plant is higher due to use of high heat resistance materials and the special manufacturing process used for the blades. Means the combustion temperature are higher in a gas turbine. That means we need to use the high heat resistance materials, and the cost of these high heat resistance material high, and special manufacturing process is required for the construction of the blade. So these blades are installed inside the turbines. Okay. So this cost of the blade is also higher. High air rate is required, means high air quantity is required to limit the maximum gas turbine inlet temperature, as a result of which the exhaust loss are high unless the waste heat is utilized. Okay, means we use the more quantity of air to reduce the temperature of combustion chambers. Okay, and if we supply this more quantity of that air, then what happened? The exhaust losses are increased. Okay, if we use the these exhaust gases for some process heating or for other applications, then these loss are avoided. Another disadvantage, part load efficiency of gas turbine is poor. So what is part load? Means suppose the capacity of the gas turbine plant is 100 megawatt and we run the gas turbine power plant below to the 100, like as 90, 80, 70 megawatts, 75 megawatts. then performance is, means efficiency is reduced. Also, plant efficiency is highly sensitive to the component efficiency, like turbine efficiency, compressor efficiency and the combustion chamber efficiency. Another disadvantage, the gas turbine plant is not self-starting unit, means they are not self-start. Okay, in IC engine what happened, we can start by using the different mechanisms, like as by the kick, by using the handles or by using this electric motor, we can easily start it. But gas turbine power plant is not self-starting. It has the starting problem, as the compressor has to be started before starting the turbines. So we know that the compressors of the gas turbine is connected with the turbine. Okay, so first we need to start the compressors. Okay, for starting these compressors we need to some external source, means by using this some other diesel engines or by using these electric motors we need to start the gas turbine. So generally diesel engine are used to start the compressors. Okay, so then the compressor is start, then combustion is going on, and then the turbine is run. So after turbine is run, the power produced by the turbine is used to run the compressors. Okay, and then after this compressor is disengaged with the diesel engines and compressor is start to run by using the turbine, means some external source is required in short. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe my channels, and don't forget to share with your friends.